with an open statement, then we'll follow questions.
Again, exciting game. It was a good win. I thought we played hard. I thought we made offensively. I thought we did a good job. Had some explosive plays. Felt like Ito again played his normal great game. I felt like out wide at receiver, we certainly had some great plays. Keon did a good job of directing the offense. Felt like defensively, we knew we had both sides of the ball. They were a good football team. I thought we did a really good job, but it guys like Curtis Michael with that pick and Cornell's play, those were just huge difference maker plays for us. And I thought for the most part, we played hard, gave ourselves a chance to win, and found a way at the end to win the ball game.
Going back and look at the film, Keon, how did y'all think you kind of?
He played well. He did, Pat. He played well. I thought he ran the offense well. I thought he threw the ball extremely well. Had a couple of really nice passes, just put it kind of in the bread basket. And again, he made plays. So I was very, very pleased with his performance.
Does it matter? He's the guy, the quadri, I guess, right now is limited. I mean,
we're kind of just waiting to see. You know how it is with the injuries. You're kind of waiting to see. Quadri can play, but, is he at 100? I don't know yet. And just watching. And so, again, we'll go out here and just watch here the first couple of days this week. But certainly we're blessed to have two young men that are playing well at that position. So we just got to see how it looks on the practice field. That's all you can go by.
When was Keon told he'd be starting?
I think we told him on Friday. We just watching them both on the practice field, felt like, he was just a little bit healthier, more solid. And it's one of those deals you take it as you watch them go through and see how they can handle things. We'll watch it and see, but we'll go with our gut.
Seemed like Keon, whatever he found the open guy for the most part.
He did, Pat. I thought he did. I thought a couple of times he made really, when there's tight coverage, he made some really good throws and put it in there. I thought he did a good job reading. I just felt like he managed the game real well. He graded out real well. Just played an outstanding game. And Coach Dawson and I both thought that he would have a really big game, and he did. He knows he's a humble guy, and he knows that's one game. But again, just pleased with the way he came out and performed.
How important getting Dorbeck back on the offensive line, having him
big.
Back?
That is big. Drake's, what a game he played. Drake played an outstanding game. Drake is, again, when you go without a 6'6" guy that's athletic as Drake is, it's never good. But Drake's a guy that's he played tough, he played physical, and I thought he's one of those guys that we're, and Tim, we, if Tim's in here, we hadn't figured out the player of the week yet, but he's one of those guys that's in the mention for it right now. We're still kind of weighing it back and forth, but he's one of those guys that's battling for that because we thought he played really good.
Did you guys put him at H-back some, him and Jerry?
Yeah, they did a good job. And both those two guys are very, very athletic.
But, that's the first time I've noticed it this year where you've moved an offensive lineman back there.
And when you got athletic guys like that, you can, But those guys did a good job.
Was it a forearm injury with Drake?
He had a little slight fracture, and I mean, he's healed up now, so he's in good shape.
Getting the ball in the hands of Ito, big part, was that kind of a big key kind of going from week to week?
Ito's Ito. I mean, we could say the same thing. It'd be like a rewind the tape, he's a guy that, Ito's a football player, he's a guy that made another big play, but he's been doing that for 3 years. I mean, he's a guy that, again, he's a football player, so, he's a guy that, and Ito's a humble guy, too, and he deserves everything he gets. He just goes to work, and I think one thing that helps is, we got other guys, too. We got Quez and Corey and, Alize. I mean, and there's other guys, too, that can make explosive plays, so that certainly helps.
Last question,
was a big win, and this week's opponent doesn't have a win. How do you, keep your guys focused in?
Well, it's conference play. In Conference USA, one thing I've learned over the years, you got to be ready every week, Alan. I think it's going to be tough. They play Western Kentucky 15-14. That, you know, and that certainly didn't get your attention. Nothing will. We know we got a good football team coming into town, and we've got to be prepared. We've got to have a great week of practice. They'll have our utmost respect again. So I think we understand we got another tough Conference USA game, and we got to get ready.
Just a clarification on Stagger's run. They said fumble, but I swear you could hear a whistle. Did they say there wasn't a whistle blown? What was the?
Well, you know, it's, you know, I think the ruling on the field, and that was my question, to be honest with you. That was my question. The officials, was the whistles blown, and I thought it was 5 or 6 yards down the field. Once the whistle blown, isn't the play dead there? I think they said up top that they ruled it in continuous motion. So therefore, that was the ruling on the field, and we certainly will respect that. And again, just got to hold on to football.
I know UTSA had some success through the year throwing the ball, but y'all took away the ground game. I know the last couple of weeks y'all given up some yardage through the air. What's kind of the concern they're going for?
You know, I think, again, I don't know. You know, you just want to play good, and you want to hold. Again, offensively, you want to score one more point, and defense, you want to hold one. That's the one thing about it. When you sit in this chair, you don't care if it's 98, 97, or 2-0. You know, at the end of the day, you just want to pick up the W. And I think the bottom line, we did some good things defensively. We knew they were a good football team. I thought, again, and we had some big plays, too, that I felt were, you know, again, game-changer plays. We knew it would be tough, Pat, a tough game. I felt like their quarterback's a good player. We knew their receivers were talented, and they'd make a few plays. But I felt like, for the most part, played a pretty good game. And I thought, kind of like that third quarter, I'd say the end of that fourth probably wasn't our best, one of our better quarters. But I thought the three quarters we really played solid.
That interception by Curtis, you know, huge, too.
Yeah, that was a big play. You know, we actually took the opening drive of the second half and went down there, and then we missed the field goal. And then they took the opening drive of the second half, and they put it down to our plus side of the field. And then the play by Curtis was huge, you know, because it gave us the ball back on the plus side with the chance to make a play. And we did make a play. Keon and Corey, I believe, made a big play there. So that was a big boost. And again, I felt like, and I talked to Jason after the game, I felt like our third quarter and early fourth this game was kind of exactly opposite of what our third and fourth was a week ago, the third and early fourth. It seemed like we made some big plays and got a nice run, where last week in the third and the early fourth, I felt like just the opposite. So good to make those plays, and gave us a little cushion.
How do you think Sangster did?
I thought he played well. I tell you, a guy that Patrick, I thought played real good, was Paxton Scripture. You know, we actually moved Paxton from outside to inside. He took to that like a duck to water, man. He played. I thought he was all over the field. And just what we asked him to do, I thought he played extremely well inside. I was pleased. I thought Joe Mays played real well defensively. I thought Joe made a lot of plays. Those two are two guys that, just looking at film, I thought, wow, they played well.
You know, talking about Paxton, he didn't get into the second series. Mm-hmm. UTSA relies a lot on momentum, mm-hmm. and getting the ball rolling downhill, especially
right,
early.
Right.
And if I remember right, their first two plays of that second drive were TFLs,
yep.
And they were both Paxton.
Yep.
So
yep.
He just seems like he's.
That's what I Jason was just watching it. I just. And Paxton's a guy that can play inside or outside, and we're fortunate to have that ability with him. But we were like, well, it's time to move Paxton back in. And Paxton, again, he's such a team player, too, an unselfish guy. You know, he's just like whatever the team needs, you know, and he goes in there, to me, just play lights out inside and just look like, you know, again, he's a football player. He can do it all.
Yeah, he just looked like he was that's a more natural position. I don't know if it's a more natural position.
He does well both. I mean, it's good to have, though. I think that's important, is you go to have sometimes those swing guys that you can move them in, you can move them out. And, again, you know, he's played both for us over the years. He's played inside and played outside. So we have that ability there. So that helps us.
Looking at him, you know, what's the challenge? Like you said, they play well last week.
Again, it's Conference USA play. Actually, they're a good football team. They played well last week. So, again, we know, we understand we're going to work. And that's our challenge each week. We want to continue. We want to get better each week. And our guys, I think, understand the challenge we have for the next 7 weeks. And we got to be ready.
I want to get this straight on Paxson. Is Ruff going to be able to go this week?
Don't know yet. Ruff's one we're still kind of watching. But again, last week, Alan, we moved Paxton inside.
We'll see.
Yeah. And Paxton can play inside or outside regardless this week. He doesn't always have to just – we have the ability with him to go, wherever we want to. But, again, we'll probably keep him inside this week, but we'll see.
And Jeremy, too, I guess just his import. I think he had like 12 tackles against North Texas and came up with a few big plays.
Jeremy's a football player again, too. I mean, Jeremy, I thought Rakeem didn't play bad either, but Jeremy's made plays, and Jeremy's a smart football player. He's a guy that, again, studies the game well, and he's does the little things right, and so he's a very instinctive player.
Offensively, you tell anything change there? I mean, did they change from last week?
There's always a little sub, but not really. I mean, at the end of the day, there's always sub on each game week. It's a different change. That's one thing I think, Patrick, you see from each team. There's always, as each team prepares, there's always a little something different. But I think. For the most part, we're 6 to 7 weeks in the season. You're not going to see with anybody you play. You're not going to see just a tremendous amount, but you'll see. I'm sure. Certainly, we're preparing for seeing changes, but you never know.
And what would you say would be UTEP's stronger points?
Well, I think to be honest with you, Alan, I think they definitely. To me, their quarterback and their running backs, they run the ball well. Their quarterback does a good job, running their offense. They give you a lot of different personnel groupings. They're very multiple on offense. So they make you work. And then defensively, they're a team that, again, they play hard. They're a football team. You watched the Western Kentucky game last week. They, to me, did a good job. Looked like they played sound football, and they just made Western Kentucky work for everything. So, they have our utmost respect, and we know we got to be ready.
Anything else? Coach, thank you.
All right, guys.